It's the largest corruption scandal in the history of football's world governing body, FIFA. In the early hours of Wednesday morning in Zurich, Swiss police stormed a luxury five-star hotel and arrested seven senior FIFA officials, including several vice presidents of the organization, most of whom are from the Americas.
And the timing may not be obviously the best, but definitely FIFA welcomes this process, and FIFA cooperates fully with the Attorney General of Switzerland and the Federal Office of Justice.
The arrests were part of a U.S. investigation, and charges include racketeering, conspiracy, and corruption, and came just a day before the annual FIFA World Congress and a vote to see whether President Sepp Blatter would win a fifth term. He was uninvolved in Wednesday's arrests.
There was never such an idea to postpone nor the Congress nor the election. As I said before, one thing has nothing to do with the other. So we go on with the agenda that you know, and the election will take place as it was planned.
In addition to the U.S. operations, Swiss authorities announced that they were launching their own investigation into the 2018 and 2022 World Cup bids. Bids that Russia and Qatar won and now are under allegations of bribery. FIFA officials said the tournaments would still go ahead as planned in both countries.
What do you expect from us? That we start to speculate and say, well, maybe Russia, Qatar, we have to redo the voting. I mean, Russia and Qatar will be played. This is what is fact today.
Phil Hahn, CNBC, London.
Hey YouTube fans, I'm Landon Dowdy from CNBC. Thanks so much for checking out our channel. Here you'll find videos packed with all the info that you need to be smarter about your finances. Be sure and subscribe by clicking right here, and click on all the videos around me to see CNBC's original series, Young Money, Tech Bet, Cramer's Mad Money, and all the latest from CNBC.